I know I've been promising this video for a while, and so I'm very happy to be sitting down to film it today. My hair has been a constant source of, I'm tempted to say, frustration, consternation, drives me crazy, but it's really like a very love-hate thing, and I honestly think that most people have a love-hate relationship with their hair. We always want what we don't have. We tend to focus on the more negative parts of our hair. So for me, the more negative parts of my hair would be that it can get unruly, very poodle-like, it has quite a bit of texture. My scalp can tend to get overly oily and greasy. My ends don't tend to get like too dry. It's sort of on the medium fine end. Yeah, it's just not wash and go hair. And I don't think a lot of people have wash and go hair, to be honest. On the positive side, I am 35 years old and I don't have to dye my hair. I'm very thankful for that. I do pluck grays, but not nearly to the point where I would have to start dyeing my hair. So I'm very appreciative of that. I do like that my hair has some texture because it will hold a style very well. I don't have dandruff or like a flaky problematic scalp. My hair grows really fast. When I take good care of it, it's not really prone to split ends and it has like nice bounce and shine and movement. I would say maybe 2 or 3 months ago, I kind of started veering into crisis territory because my hair just was not getting clean. I had been using the same sort of products for the last couple of years. That should have been my first clue that hair product cycling is a real thing and you do need to do it. At least in my experience, you do need to do it. As far as my evolution with hair care, I'll just give you like a very brief synopsis. I've never really excessively treated my hair, like never really color treated it, although I did go through a period of very unfortunate caramel colored highlights in college, which would just get very brassy, and I had no idea what brassy hair even was then, so I just looked like ridiculous, honestly. And then after a bad home hair dye job, I had to have my hair color corrected professionally and re-dyed my natural color, and I never dyed it again. I did have a semi-permanent dye put in this past fall. It was very subtle. I don't think very many people could tell, which is what I wanted. It was sort of like a cocoa chocolate cherry color for fall, and I liked it and I would totally do it again. November, December. If you watch videos from around that time, I had like a semi-permanent dye in my hair, which has subsequently washed out and my hair just totally went back to normal. I started using eco products around the time that I was switching out all of my personal care products, which was right around it was basically in the 2010 to 2012 timeframe. That was when I was like deep diving into eco beauty. And I started using brands like Intelligent Nutrients, Yarok, and Rawa. They were like the three main brands at the time. Eco hair care has expanded, but I do have to say I'm not sure that the performance is really where it needs to be as far as keeping up with conventional products. And this is like a whole broader discussion. In fact, I just went through this with nail care products. I don't know how many of you follow me on Instagram, but I had a back and forth with the nail polish brand AILA. And part of what came out of my email conversation and the note I got back from the founder is it's true. Like, I don't think it's necessarily always fair to hold eco products to their conventional counterpoints standards. When you are taking out particular chemicals and changing the formula, you do have to sort of sometimes adjust your expectations. By and large, I feel like I've done that, especially with eco hair care. I've made a lot of sort of concessions, especially with styling products. I mean, there are some really, really good eco shampoos and conditioners, as you'll see when we go into my bathroom and I show you all of the products. But basically, long story short, what ended up happening is I've been using eco formulations of hair care products for the last, like, how many years is that? Like, 5 plus 6 7. I've tried everything. I've tried John Masters Organics. I've tried shampoo bars. I've tried apple cider vinegar rinses, and I had settled on a sort of select number of products that really worked for me. This was the Evolve H Ultra Shine shampoo and conditioner and the Innersense Pure Harmony shampoo, which is their sort of more lightweight one, not the super moisturizing one. Then I was also having really good success with the Rare Elements shampoo, and then, like, everything stopped working all at once. Over the span of a couple months, so October, November-ish, my hair was just not getting clean at all. Like, I would wash it at night. I generally wash my hair at night, let it air dry, style it in the morning. It would be greasy by the afternoon the next day. And I was like, this is not okay. I was usually, had always been able to go make it like 3 days using dry shampoo and stuff, of course, but it was not a stretch for me to go 2 to 3 days, wash my hair every other day or every 2 to 3 days. And my hair just was not getting clean. And I was like, what is going on? I started feeling like I needed a really good clarifying shampoo or like clarifying product, because it was an issue really with my scalp. My scalp would just had a lot of buildup, it felt like, and was maybe even excessively producing oil, I don't know. I mentioned it in like a previous video and I got lots of good recommendations. A lot of people recommended Aveda and I was like, yeah, I should try Aveda again. And it was a good exercise for me in realizing that you can never, at least I feel like, you can never completely wed yourself to one way of doing things. Like, things are going to change. Your body is going to change. Your chemistry is going to change. Lots of external variables you can't control are going to change. And there is absolutely no shame and nothing wrong with going back to products that you used to use, but then somehow became vilified in your mind because of toxins and chemicals. I'm so still, like, I made a video last year about how, I don't even know the word for it, just how unhappy I had become with what the eco beauty space had turned into. It's like gone off the rails as far as I'm concerned. And I just don't interact with it as much anymore. So I don't get as upset all the time about it. I don't think that people are bad people or that you're going to die of cancer if you use Aveda or if you use like Tide cleaning detergents. It's just the level of how myopic and misguided all of that has become makes me like angry, frankly. That said, I do think that most of us are interested in more natural formulations, because as much as we can, we like to make choices that are, you know, hopefully part of a broader range of choices that are contributing to healthy bodies and healthy communities and a healthy planet. But obviously realizing that we can't quarantine ourselves from society and life, and that you're not going to die if you don't ever use organic products. I'm going off the rails because it's just made me so disaffected. I've become disaffected with a lot of parts of mainstream society, to be honest. So I think it's just the times that we're living in and how the visible display of all of that stuff gets played out on social media and the news and things like that. Okay, back to hair. I realized I just wanted to start using some more conventional products again. So as you'll see, I picked several up. They have really been working for me. I've gone back to try and use some of the more natural products like Innersense and Evolve Age, and my hair will get greasy within like 12 hours. So it's interesting. I don't actually know what the culprit is. I don't know if, you know, they say that cycling products for your hair is a real thing, that your hair can get, your hair and your scalp can get used to a product and it will stop working. So I have absolutely found that to be the case. And even using new products, trying to go back to the old ones, at least right now, is not working. And this is just for shampoos. I didn't experience any issues with conditioners or styling products. So it's really just about getting my scalp clean. I have had people say, well, have you done an apple cider vinegar rinse? That method has honestly never really worked for me. I went through probably a 6-month period in 2014 where I was using a shampoo bar and doing apple cider vinegar rinses, and my hair has never looked worse. Sorry, like, I'm just not into the whole idea of like detoxing your scalp and your body. Like, I will take the surfactants and the cleansing agents. That's just my preference right now. I tried and it did not work, and I don't see myself trying again. The other thing I wanted to mention is I had a thought that it could have been my shower filter issue. So I do have one of these rain shower filter. It's like a shower head attachment, and I haven't changed the filter in a while. I mean, they're technically only good 6 to 8 months. So I bought a replacement shower filter thinking that this could also help. Yeah, it's a dechlorinating shower filter. This could be part of it, but honestly, once I switched products, my hair started behaving again. So I don't think that it was necessarily that, although this can't hurt. And I am still planning to switch out the filter, except I can't get my current filter open. So I need someone with more muscles to come do that for me, because I'm having issues. That might be all that I have to say. I'm really happy with the products that I'm using. My hair is back to functioning in a way that I'm comfortable with it. I also got a really good trim lately, and that seemed to help. I probably took two and a half inches off. It's funny, right? Like, even though you're taking hair off the bottom, I feel like it totally affects the health of like your entire head of hair when you have a really good trim. So I try and get trims every 10 weeks if I can. Anything more than 10, like 12 at the max, and I can start to feel like my hair is just not happy. The only other thing I would say is that I need to get back into a more regular scalp treatment, and my favorite product for that I don't currently have is the Uma hair oil. It was a Beauty Heroes hero from quite a while ago, and it's the only product, especially at that price point, for that genre of product that I would spend money on at that level again. I also think that Reverie does a hair scalp serum. It's like called the Cake Hair Serum that I'm curious about. Yeah, I'm kind of babbling now, so why don't I take you into my bathroom, show you kind of where we're at as far as Mercedes Hair Chronicles, whatever chapter this is.
So I'm going to talk you through all of the hair products that I'm sort of currently using. This metal crate just stays in my shower, which is like right behind the frame of the camera. Why don't we start with the things that I was using and sort of stopped working, unfortunately. As far as shampoos, I've been using this, the Evolve Age Ultra Shine shampoo, for quite a long time. This is, I think, my second or third full-size one of these, and I had gone through lots of little ones. So this was in heavy rotation. This is an almost empty Innersense Pure Harmony hair bath shampoo. This is my second or third one of these. I had been using this very religiously, and actually over here you can see I already had another one sort of all ready to go. And then this was the other one. It looks a little grody, but this is the Rare Elements Pure Shampoo. So the top just, I'm sorry, it looks super, super gross. That's kind of embarrassing. Yeah, that's the deal. This is the first full-size one of these I had ever had. So my hair routine was basically consisting of usually a first wash with one of these, the Evolve H or the Rare Elements, and then I was always following it up with a second wash with the Innersense Pure Harmony shampoo. Then for conditioner, I was using the Yarok Feature Volume. This is like a very lightweight conditioner. So I would either use this alone, or sometimes I would layer them if my hair needed lots of moisture. I would use this one for much more sort of lightweight conditioning, I guess. So then basically all of that stuff stopped working, as you heard me say previously. So some of the things that I picked up to start changing my routine, not eco, I really felt like I needed products that were not eco-formulated. I wanted some harsher surfactants. I wanted things that were really going to get my hair clean. So this was actually in a previous favorites video. It's the Aveda Scalp Benefits. You can see I'm making like pretty good progress through it. I'm really liking this. I use this a couple of times a week. And then I had also wanted to try this line from Aveda, Invati line, which I don't really like as much. It's such a weird, let's see if I can like, it's very, very liquidy. Well, actually that doesn't look like quite as runny as it had been looking. It had just been feeling like really, really watery for whatever reason. So what I've been doing is sort of mixing them. Maybe once a week I'll mix a little bit of this in with the Aveda Scalp Benefits. And I will say they're effective at getting my hair clean, but I'm not sure that I would, you know, purchase a full-size bottle of the Invati line. I heard that they reformulated this, that it used to actually be much better. So this actually is eco. This is the Giovanni Tea Tree Triple Treat Invigorating Shampoo. I ended up going for a full size of this, which is like win-win because it's not an eco luxe product at all. It's very inexpensive, $10 a bottle on Vitacost. I discovered it because I had needed a travel shampoo, and this was the sort of the sample size that my local Whole Foods carries. You can see I've gone through a whole one of these, and I bought a new one just to have for travel. So that's kind of how I discovered how good it was. It's actually very, very clarifying, gently clarifying to the scalp, and I found that it was really getting my hair clean. I did the full size bottle of it, and I sort of alternate this with the Aveda Scalp Benefits. I usually wash my hair every 2 to 3 days, so every 2 or 3 washes I'll do this one, the next wash I'll do the Scalp Benefits, so that's kind of how it's been working out. Okay, so then kind of for more explicitly clarifying products, I picked up two products. The Bumble and Bumble Sunday Shampoo, which I'd heard so many good things about, and then a small travel size of the Christophe Robin Sea Salt Purifying Scrub. So let me talk about this one first because I'm pretty sure I'm going to return it. You know, I wish they had smaller sizes of this one, but I did get it at Sephora. I've used it, I think, 3 times, and I just don't think it's really like anything special at all. So I'm going to return it. I wanted to show it in this video, and then I had every intention of returning it. I find that the Giovanni shampoo basically has the same effect on my hair. For a clarifying product, I actually want something that's going to sort of strip and dry out my hair. I realize that perhaps not everybody wants that, but I don't dye or highlight my hair regularly, so to me this honestly just was not clarifying enough. I didn't feel that it did anything more for my hair than the Aveda Scalp Benefits or this Giovanni one. On the other hand, this is probably my favorite product of this entire video. It is absolutely incredible. Let's get a real close-up going. You guys, it's so good. So the full size jar of this, it comes in a much bigger jar, is around $50, I think. But they sell this little smaller size, which is, let's see, 2.7 fluid ounces or 75 mils. This is $19 on Sephora's website. I couldn't find it in store, but you can get this one online. So first of all, it smells incredible. It's very, very fresh smelling, but you need the smallest amount. And as a weekly treatment, massage into your scalp, a small amount sudses up like a ton. I don't even really want to look at the ingredients, to be honest. I mean, this is just a product that is so good that I'm kind of willing to put up with whatever's in it, honestly. This is exactly what I needed to really get my scalp super clean. I heard so many raves about this. I did also hear a few people say that it turned their hair into straw. So be wary of that. I basically need my hair to get a little bit dried out, and this just gives me so much volume, and it's incredible. Like, I can't rave about it enough. A couple good friends of mine have bought it on my recommendation and have been similarly wowed. And I think the friends that I'm thinking of also have my hair type, which is sort of medium fine textured. If you're able to order just this little $19 travel one on Sephora with the possibility of returning it, I think you have nothing to lose trying it. I had heard more raves about this one than the Briogeo charcoal like scalp mask. That's another one I was considering trying, but I'm really glad I went for this one first because it's just been exceptional. And then for conditioners, I've still just been using these because honestly, I think the real problem for me was not the conditioner, it was the shampoo. So I've been opting more for the Yarok Feature Volume, which is a much lighter weight one. I'll really only use the Evolve H if I'm feeling like my ends are sort of dry, and I just had a really good trim, so my ends have not really been that dry. But this is great. My only issue is that Yarok, in the early stages of the Trump administration, seemed to be posting like pro-Trump Melania photos on their feed, which made me really uncomfortable and made me unsure whether I wanted to keep buying them as a brand, to be honest. So I had bought this well before the election. It's not moisturizing at all. So if you're someone that is needing a very, very lightweight conditioner and you don't care about the political stance of brands, then you could consider this one. So I don't know. I probably have about that much in here. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do when it's gone, honestly. Okay, the other product I could tell you about is the Innersense Hydrating Hair Mask. You know, I've only used this a couple times, especially because I don't need like a super, super hydrating product, but I think what I'm probably going to do is just use this as sort of a leave-on conditioner in the shower, like similar to the Evolve H one. I have used it as a hair mask. I haven't noticed it to be like anything beyond just a sort of a rich conditioner, but it does smell really, really good. It smells like the rest of Innersense's like super moisturizing range. Sorry, I'm having some focusing issues, but it's really, really quite nice. They sent this to me to try. Yeah, I think it's nice, especially if you have sort of dry, curly hair. That's sort of what Innersense is known for. I have two other things here that I haven't tried yet, but they're gonna go into this basket for me to start trying. The Captain Blankenship Mermaid Conditioner and Shampoo. So these are supposed to be a texturizing shampoo with sea salt and marine extracts. I really like the sound of that because sea salt can tend to be slightly drying to the hair, which again, is something that I'm sort of looking for right now. I haven't even opened this or smelled them. Let me do that really quickly. I just gave this a whiff and it has a sort of a very bright citrus, almost like lemon meringue, key lime pie sort of scent. So really quite pleasant. and the conditioner has the same scent. So they are matching, and I'm just gonna have to let you know, I haven't really honestly heard very much about these. A company reached out to send them to me. These are carried at Sephora as well, so the thing that's nice about shopping on Sephora is that if you don't like something, you can return it for your money back, which is sort of hard to do with eco beauty products. I'll have those linked down below if you'd like to go check them out on Sephora's website, but I'll just have to let you guys know once I've given these a fair try. The other thing I could tell you about is I have these Rawa shampoo and conditioner minis. I haven't used them yet. I think these came in the Detox Market Best of 2017 beauty box. And I just have these reserved for travel, but honestly, like, I haven't been able to tear myself away from the Giovanni Tea Tree Triple Treat, but I do kind of want to give these a try. I tried them many, many years ago when I was first getting into eco beauty, and it was really just like Rawa and Yarok that were kind of dominating the eco beauty hair scene. At the time, I didn't feel like these were sort of getting my hair clean enough. So given all of my hair issues recently, I sort of have a hard time believing that they'll be good for me now, but I'm certainly willing to try. They do sort of have a Palo Santo-ish scent. Yeah, very woodsy, kind of medicinal. Yeah, they're nice. I think that they're, especially if you got that box, they're worth trying. And I realize I didn't really say much about some of these other products that I was using, the Rare Elements. This is probably one of the highest end sort of eco hair care ranges, this, and for example, like the Philia B line, which I'm actually sort of curious about. This is very, very heavy and moisturizing, so I just don't think it's, they do a light, or I don't know if they do a light version of the shampoo. I know they do a light version of the conditioner. You know, this was okay. It was one of those products I could never really decide if I liked or didn't like, so I'm not sure if I'll finish it. I haven't touched it in a long time. Similar, like, this has been sitting upside down in here since I had like a hair freak out and just stopped using these two. And then I will still try and use this one sometimes, but when I use this, my hair is greasy the next day. I honestly think, as I said in my little intro, that it was just an issue of my hair rebelling against products I had been using for too long without rotating. I really have been having a lot of success with the scalp benefits, with the Giovanni Tea Tree Triple Treat, and with this Christophe Rabon scrub as sort of a treatment. Everything else is sort of still up in the air, and that's really it. The only other things you're seeing in here, this is the shaving cream I use, so not hair related, but I like this a lot, the Giovanni Invigorating Tea Tree and Mint Shave Cream. Because I like the shampoo so much, I was like, let me revisit Giovanni. I used to use them in like 2005, 2006, and then just kind of maxed out, honestly. And then this is a body care product. This is the Linné Activate Scrub that also hangs out in here. Now I want to show you where I keep the a lot of my styling products, and then I have some other larger ones that stay in a drawer near where I do my makeup that I'll show you. But if you saw my recent skincare cabinet tour, then I showed everything except this little cubby, which is all hair, and I knew I was going to be doing this Hair Chronicles video, so I saved it to show you. Okay, so right here in the front are these new Modern Minerals products, and actually I do keep one of them up here because I have not been using it for hair. This is the Hydrating Mist, and I don't need a hydrating mist for my hair. It's almost sort of like a hydrosol, honestly. So I've been using it in conjunction with hand moisturizers to kind of like amp up like a hand cream, or just sort of like spraying on my body as sort of like a body toner situation, something like this. So this is the Texture Mist, the dry shampoo, and the styling jelly. So I absolutely love these two, the styling jelly and the dry shampoo. The texturizing mist, I'm still kind of trying to figure out if I like or not. I mean, it definitely does give sort of grit to the hair, but it makes my hair feel a little bit dirty, which is not sort of my favorite feeling. I think if I had thicker hair or even more curly hair, I might like it a little better. So I'm still sort of playing around with this one. The dry shampoo, I am really in love with. The other dry shampoo in here that I have is Stark's dry shampoo, which I like, but I will say it's, you know, probably, you can see I have used quite a bit. It's sort of the dry shampoo I've been exclusively using over the last year. I really, really like the Modern Minerals one. It has a sort of light, pleasant flower essence scent. Okay, so I want to kind of show you how it comes out, because I think it is sort of quite noteworthy. It's quite gritty, and I don't know how well you can see the color, but it's almost like a pink clay color, and it's quite, there's like a heft to it. In the past, I have not liked dry shampoos that are sort of gritty and granular. The one that it sort of reminds me of is the Tabitha James Cron one, which I did not get on with like at all. But this one is such a good version. Whereas the Stark one, for example, is sort of much more traditional dry shampoo, lightweight, sort of a poofy white powder. So the scent of the Stark one is a vetiver, and I think, yeah, it's sort of like a woodsy vetiver, which I also like, but it does sort of feel a little bit more powdery in the hair, and yeah, it just kind of depends, I think, on your preference. So those are my two dry shampoos right now. The other one that I really like is the Lulu Organics dry shampoo. That would be the only other one that I would consider buying at the moment. The Styling Jelly by Modern Minerals, I love. This might actually be my favorite product in this new little bundle of her products. So for me, it's similar to something like the John Masters Organics Hair Pomade, which I really like. This, I actually think this is such an underrated sort of product. You can see I've used quite a bit, and I think this is my second tin. I just really, really like this for texturizing the ends of my hair if I'm gonna put it up in a top knot, or yeah, even if just sort of my ends are looking dry. Now, the difference between this and Styling Jelly is that this does make your hair ends look a little bit sort of like greasier and oilier, whereas this one is more sort of a little bit weightless. It's almost like a really, really good flexible hair gel. I use a very small amount, like a dime-sized amount, just kind of run through the ends of my hair. It smells so good. It's the flower essence smell, but something else as well. It's so, so good. I love this product. Okay, then I also have Stark Tendril as a hair oil. And then the only other hair oil I currently have is that I'm testing actually, is the Activist Hair and Scalp Oil. Packaging's very pretty. This is very, very sort of tea tree heavy. It's really quite astringent smelling. I think this would be good if you are really sort of having problem scalp issues, like dry, flaky scalp, and you need like a more treatment hair oil. I haven't found that I've been getting a ton of use out of it just because I don't have like a very dry, problematic scalp right now. This you can also use as a scalp treatment, but I like this more as a very lightweight heat protectant, or again, just sort of like a styling medium, like one or two drops is perfect on the ends of my hair. I reviewed this very extensively in my Stark brand review, but it's formulated explicit. It's like a hair oil explicitly for people with finer hair, so it doesn't look as oily on the ends. So this is great. I've used probably half of my bottle. It has a geranium and ylang ylang scent, which to me translates as kind of like an old school bubblegum smell, but I really quite enjoy it. Okay, this is one of my leave-in products. It's the Reverie Hair Milk, which I really, really like. This, I think, was in my Best of Beauty 2016 or 17, and it's great. It's just a lightweight leave-in hair conditioner that I sort of treat as a heat protectant, even though I don't think it's explicitly a heat protectant, but it's really, really good. I think particularly if you have frizzy hair or any sort of texture to your hair, this is really versatile. You can use it before blow drying, before heat styling with curling iron or flat iron, or you can just use a little bit as a styling medium after your hair has already been styled, smooth flyaways and that kind of thing. I've used about half or two-thirds of this bottle, and I would absolutely repurchase it. And then I have two other little styling products back here. This is the Aveda Volumizing Tonic that I wanted to try sort of on a whim when I bought the scalp benefits and the other little shampoo that you saw. It's okay. You're supposed to spray a little bit into your roots while it's damp and then blow dry. And you do have to blow dry it to kind of activate the volume building. I just don't blow dry my hair a lot. I sort of prefer to let my hair air dry most of the time. But even when I do, I don't find that the effect is really that amazing. Could be that I'm just not using enough. The nice thing about it is you don't really feel a lot of buildup in your hair from it, and I don't like to weigh my hair down with too many styling products, so I'm still kind of on the fence with this one. And then this came in a recent Sephora order. It was sort of like a little deluxe perk. It's the Briogeo Blow Dry Perfection and Heat Protectant Cream. It's actually pretty nice. It's sort of similar to the Reverie product, sort of a lightweight cream. The only thing is, sometimes I find Briogeo products just too scented. They're not as scented as something like Living Proof, for example, or Dry Bar. Like, I can't use those products because they're way too fragranced. But Briogeo, for being kind of like a more natural brand, I'm sort of like, let's take the fragrance down a notch, dude, you know? But actually, it is okay. Let me show you the texture. So it looks like that, and I'll show you against the Reverie Hair Milk. So there's the Briogeo, the Reverie, and then I also kind of want to show you the Modern Mineral Styling Jelly, which I just really adore. So Modern Mineral Styling Jelly, Briogeo Heat Protectant Cream, Reverie Hair Milk. So I do have a couple of other products that stay in a larger drawer, and these are two Intelligent Nutrient products, the Leave-In Conditioner and the Intelligent Nutrients Perfect Hold Hairspray. I've gone through like countless ones of these. They're some of the first products that I was using when I got into Eco Beauty in like 2010-11. Yeah, it's like bottle 3 or 4 for each of these. So the thing you should know is that they're really not that high performing if you compare them to conventional hair care, but for some reason I really like them. They're sort of an amped up version, natural wise, of Aveda. Like, they smell like Aveda products, but even like a next level hippie smell, I guess. The leave-in conditioner is sort of similar to Reverie Hair Milk for me. It's more lightweight, actually. This one is a little bit heavier and more moisturizing, but I really like it. To be honest, it just kind of depends what I feel like smelling in my hair. It doesn't leave any residue really, and it's very it doesn't sort of like build up really in the hair. The Perfect Hold Hairspray, this is, you know, I've gone through several of these. I don't use very much at all. This is what the packaging looks like. I hope that these are not discontinued. They can be a little hard to get a hold of. I don't even know who carries them anymore. I think I've gotten mine on like Beauty Bar or Beauty Bay or something before. I don't even remember. This is kind of what I use like every day. If I'm styling my hair, I'll do just a light spritz. It doesn't leave my hair crunchy, which I really appreciate. I have tried other eco hairsprays. Like, I've tried the Innersense one, I've tried the Josh Rosebrook one, I've tried the Captain Blankenship one, and I just don't like any of them compared to this. This doesn't leave any sort of crunch in my hair at all, but it gives a very, very light hold. So I like it. For more sort of special occasions, I do have the Bumble and Bumble Spray de Mode. So I'll alternate between getting small ones of this as well as the Bumble and Bumble Does It All. But I very rarely even use this anymore. I was using this if I was like doing like a hair extension, big, huge bun, or like an updo or sleek pony with hair extensions. I rarely am doing that these days, but I do like to keep a bottle of like the real stuff around for when I need it. The only other thing I do have is the Orbe Dry Texturizing Spray. I mean, what kind of beauty blogger would I be if I didn't have this? Eco or not, and I have to say, I do really like it. I use it like, I don't know, probably 2 or 3 times a month. I've had this for probably 2 years, and I've used 2/3 of it, probably half or 2/3. And I do like it. I mean, it's very perfumed. I know I was just saying that I couldn't deal with Living Proof or Dry Bar, but Orbe is just, it's very luxe. I mean, it's very hard to replicate the effect that a product like this gives your hair in a more natural formulation. I actually did also just order a travel size of the Orbe Original Shampoo because I've heard very good things about it, to kind of put in my rotation. I find that I have better success when I don't spray it like directly into my roots. I just don't like the way that it feels, but I'll sort of spray from underneath my hair, and it does give just kind of a piecey, slightly gritty textured movement, and like, it's nice hair perfume, honestly, too, as well, if you like the scent, which I do.
So I hope you enjoyed seeing all of my products up close and hearing my thoughts on them. This was a highly requested video, and I hope that it was useful for you. I'm always open to product recommendations, eco or not. I love trying new things, seeing what works. Hair is such a finicky thing, though. It's really very individual, so it's one of those products that's a little hard to review because it's going to depend so much also on like your own water supply, the season season and your chemistry and all of that. There's just a lot of mitigating factors. Take everything here with obviously like a grain of salt, that it's just what's working for me. And if you got some new insight and ideas, then I did my job. Everything I talked about will be listed and linked below for your reference. I will also end with saying there are several brands I'm quite curious about trying next. One of them is the brand Davines or Devens. I sound like a moron. I've heard a lot of people talk about this brand, and when I was querying for good hair product recommendations, a lot of people recommended this brand to me. I've seen Carolyn Hirons sing their praises, and they are more naturally formulated with good ingredients. The brand Philia B, I'm very curious about, but it's very expensive. I read somewhere that it's the brand that Tata Harper uses on her hair. The like luxe seeking part of me is very curious about them. I'm curious to sort of sample the Orbe shampoos, because I was talking to a friend and it was like right when I was in the middle of my hair woes, and I was like, I just cannot get my scalp clean. She was like, I went through the same thing. I think maybe she's a little bit older than me, and she had said that she had gone through the same thing. So it could just be an age-related hormonal change, like that pains me, but you know, time is marching on. But she said she uses the sort of signature Orbe shampoo. She said the one in the black bottle, and that she only has to wash her hair like twice a week now. So I just bought a sample size of that to try. I've tried the Gold Blush shampoo and I really liked it. And then another product that I would like to try is the Shampoo dry shampoo from Aveda. I've heard very good things about that, in addition to the Lulu Organics dry shampoo, because dry shampoo is a product category that is sort of like a necessary evil, but I think a lot of us really dislike the way it feels in our scalp and in our hair. It's almost like you put it in to get through the day, but you cannot wait to wash your hair. Yeah, I don't know. I would prefer to not use an aerosol dry shampoo either, even though I know that those are very popular. I think those are my main shopping list items for hair care. I cannot say enough good things about that Christophe Robin sea salt scrub. It is transformative on a level I can't even fully gush about in this video. It's very, very good. So why don't we just close out this video here? I hope that you all are having an amazing weekend. I am excited to see you in an upcoming video. Make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss any of my videos. I am over very actively on Instagram. I am over on Patreon. I just posted another live stream, Get Ready With Me live stream, from this past Friday. So that is over there if you would like more L'Amour content. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you very soon. Bye.